think one of the things that I wanted to say is that when we talk about equality and freedom of religion, we seem to be talking about them as mutually exclusive things. And I really don't think that they have to be. When it comes to equality, we also have to consider that we cannot discriminate against religious people simply for their religious beliefs. And just as we abhor the concept of a religious state dictating that everyone believes X, I think we have to consider that we might be suggesting the exact same thing, but from a different angle, one that we find to be more socially acceptable to our liberal sentiment. And I think that that's a real problem. And, you know, when we say things like, well, you know, this religion is wrong for discrimination, well, I wonder if it's discrimination or if it's just exclusion. And that is the real key difference between, the real key factor in a group is discrimination. It's outlining these people and not these ones for whatever reasons.
Well, there's so much to really talk about here. I just wanted to reaffirm what Mark just made. And the idea that there's an inconsistency between equality and freedom of religion, it seems to be completely wrong. On the contrary, freedom of religion is based on the basic ideas of freedom and equality. It's only because we have basic normative ideas of freedom and equality that we can deduce the idea of freedom of religion. That's one point. The second point regarding harm, I'm a victim of male circumcision and didn't do me too much good, but I can't imagine what it'd be like for a female circumcision. And to say that consent is a sufficient ground for accepting some barbaric practice just seems to be nonsense. There are all kinds of practices that people have consented to, which they would not have consented to unless they were intimidated in some manner or form. So, that sounds to me to be absurd. The main point is that it doesn't seem to me that there should or could be a contrast between freedom of religion and freedom and equality in general. One follows from the other.
Sam, and then?
Yes. I'm very concerned when we talk about what's best for everybody, when people within the religious institution spout hatred towards other groups, not only the effect it has on people within the congregation, but the outside community. And I really appreciate you speaking to that.
One last.
I would love to have that chance.
I'll go a bit further than the gentleman two people ago. There is a novel in which children are raised in schools essentially to have their organs used as for people surviving. They give their consent. They've never known anything else. But they have been raised ideologically to believe that this is their duty, this is their service, and they should do it. So here you have consent. So consent, people are raised to believe things. This is sort of suddenly there, a truth that strikes them from above. And if they're raised properly, they'll consent to them or anything.
Okay.
No, I can't answer every single question at all. But let me inject a little realism into this, that is political realism. In 1992, we modernized the Canadian Human Rights Act. That's the Human Rights Act that governs, employment in the military, in, Canadian transport, all that kind of stuff. Nothing religious. What we wanted to do, the biggie, was to put in sexual orientation as a prohibited ground of discrimination. It had been found by courts that it really had to be in the act, but it wasn't in there in black letter law. And the deputy said to me, Dixon, you're going to run this task force. Figure out how to draft the law, but for Christ's sake, get some support for it. So I said, great, well, where do the organized religions in? We're not asking them not to discriminate, we're asking them to say, we support fairness and equity for gay people in the workplace, in the non-religious workplace. And they came and met. I met with the Canadian Council of Catholic Bishops, I met with every evangelical group, I met with all of them. And they said with thin lips, we don't hate the sinners, John. We just hate the sin. And it couldn't help but make me think about Rousseau's comment that religious people cannot help but hate those that they believe their God has damned. There wasn't a single goddamned religion that would sign on except the Unitarians, and of course they didn't believe in much at all. that didn't give us the juice we needed. But when it came down to Cracker Jack, will you step up to the plate and say to your congregations, with respect to gay people out there in the workplace, not here in our soup kitchen or teaching our kids, will you stand up and say, this is something we should support, and we're telling the government that, you know, we're not going to vote against them just because they did this. I heard quite the opposite from all of them.
Did you ask the United Church of Canada?
Yeah, and they were sort of, you know, at that point...
out there on everything else.
This is 1993. Things have gone a long way since then.
No, we started at 1988.
Yeah. I didn't hear much support from them.